family. According to Brandon's Oxford Dictionary and Thesaurus, a family is a group of related plants, animals, or things. Ammon would throw in a complicated something or two about genetics. Maggie would add that it's the group of nuts she has to deal with. Savannah instantly thinks of an army of beggars, and Bree would say the word reminds her of a movie, but these names may mean nothing to you. Forgive me, I have not properly introduced the Watkins. A is for Ammon, as in Amun, Amun Ra. Look up Ammon at the source, and the antonym would be Wanker. Ammon professes to be uncool, because he's never cared about what others think. However, this is one of many things that does make him cool. A genius scientist in his late 20s, already published in this field, Ammon is the Alice Cooper of the science community. Bill Nye with a head full of heavy metal. Mr. Wizard with a mohawk.
I'm a movie star, I can do just about an octopus.
In the creation of all videos, Ammon became an invaluable co-director and co-editor, whom I could not have done without. It should go without saying, anyone who can argue both sides of an argument just for the fun of it belongs in my good books.
So why is it we always feel sympathetic for people who are getting revenge? It's our natural state.
B is for Brandon, as in bombastic, a living antonym of banal. In his early 50s, this is a man who actually does walk around with a dictionary in his back pocket. He possesses
vernacular power!
Every few days, Brandon introduces new, bizarre vocabulary into the lives of those around him.
Necromancy, the supposed art of predicting the future by communicating with the dead.
I shall help you.
God of Hormone, rise! Rise!
I'm so sorry, here. I'll just rub your temples, your headache. Oh, boy, someday.
For the self-deprecating, side-splitting humor. This is a man who can say and do absolutely anything with a straight face while the world rolls on the floor around him and while Maggie rolls her eyes. B is also for Brienne, sidekick of Brandon. If you've ever watched cartoons, you've seen a glimpse of Bree. She's the exaggerated and comical character whose head remains in the clouds. Someone who watches so many movies that her personality has become, over time, a conglomeration of scenes and characters. In her early 20s, Bree has lots of energy, doing flips and stretches with a smile plastered on her face. And when I say that Bree belongs in one of those cheerleading movies, and then tell you that saying so makes her ecstatic, I think you get a taste of who she is. M is for Maggie, the mom and mediator of this wild assortment. In her late 40s, Maggie seems to be the most normal of the bunch, though that still isn't saying much. Honest and genuine, with an inner flame that leaps out the moment someone tries to rip her off, Maggie wants the cheap price, the right price, and she wants it now. Down to earth and rational, Maggie's insistence to stop worrying and start living is inspiring. So far, it's brought the family this far, and I have a feeling it will carry them all further. S is for Savannah, strangest creature on this planet. In her late teens, Savannah defies all possible explanation. This is the girl who, upon learning that the fruit she wanted to eat was rotten, just picked the worms out and ate those instead.
I'm so scared!
Someone who has turned whining into a fine art. Savannah's boyfriend, Grady, seems to have an unlimited amount of patience with her antics.
Shimmering, splendid. Tell me, princess, now when did you last let your heart decide? I can open your eyes, take you wonder by wonder, over, sideways, and under, on a magic carpet ride, a whole new fantastic point of view. No one to tell us no, or where to go, or say we're only dreaming.
A whole new world, a
younger sister, some of the typical sisterly love is present.
I don't have to get water to my hearing.
Down in over 35 countries, Egypt was where the life of the Watkins crossed my own life lines. Now that fate has brought us together, I can only hope that fortune will keep it that way. For the presence in my life has been nothing but blessings. And who am I? Well, that's another.